All right, so we got the inverse tangent. So y equals the inverse tangent of x means x equals the tangent of y. So this is true. So how should I put this? Like if you have a standard, so if you have f of negative 1 of x, you get out x. If you have f of negative 1 of f of x, if they're both truly inverses of each other, and they're limited by the domains, they state, so you can do this because they say they limit their domains and range or for x and y. So in this instance, as you can see here, it does work out because they do limit the range, so it's a valid function. So, you know, if you plug in x, the x and y's can swap here. So if you plug in, so x and y here will approximately get you out the same thing as y, assuming you keep the same values here. So they swap out appropriately. Anyway, I hope that helps. This is true. And there you go.